Greetings all in the precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and welcome to a new week of Brian's Bible Break as we unpack verses from God's Word and reflect on them. This morning we're in Proverbs chapter 4, verse 23, reading from the New International Version. Let's begin with a word of prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you and praise you for this glorious day. We're so grateful, O God, to be welcomed into your holy presence, to pause and to reflect on your Word, to receive a word of encouragement and hope from you. And so, God, we pray that you will quiet within us any voice but your own in the name of Jesus Christ, that we may hear your still small voice speaking to us in this moment of pausing and reflection. And we ask this in the precious name of Jesus Christ. Amen. So, Proverbs chapter 4, verse 23. Above all else, guard your heart, for everything you do flows from it. And the book of Proverbs, as you are no doubt familiar, is a book of wisdom, and it is filled with short pieces of wisdom for us, short verses, pithy statements to help guide us on our journey with the Lord. And so when you read through the book of Proverbs, you find that in a lot of cases, unlike the other books of the Bible, it's not written in a very literary form, in that it's not in paragraphs or sentences or thought streams of thought like some of the other books of the Bible. And and so we have this one verse here, which is part of a larger teaching by Solomon, the author of Proverbs. But this one verse jumped out at me. It says, above all else, guard your heart. In other words, and we need to protect our hearts. We need to have our hearts set on the Lord. It's why it was said of David that he had a heart seeking after God's own heart. He had a desire to have a pure and clean heart. And of course, we know that he was not perfect, and he had issues with sin in his own life, as do all of us. But the author of Proverbs, Solomon, is encouraging us to guard our hearts. And we live in a world today very different from the day of Solomon, when we are bombarded from every direction with messages that go against the teachings of Scripture, that speak contrary to God's Word. And we are literally bombarded with our eyes, with our ears, and if we aren't careful, our hearts. And so we have to guard our hearts against the teachings and the ways and the practices of this world, so that we may continue to walk in step with Holy Spirit, living our lives in accordance with God's will and God's command. He says, above all else, guard your heart, for everything you do flows from it. Everything you do flows from it. It's an interesting statement. But I think there's some truth to that statement. When our hearts are filled with joy, joy flows from us. When our hearts are filled with anger, anger flows from us, or bitterness, or rage, or any other emotion. And I can speak from experience that there was a time when I was very angry, bitter man, and that's what proceeded from me. That's what I portrayed in the world. And thanks be to God, I'm not there anymore. I've been set free from that bitter root that resided in me. I've been set free from that condition of my heart that was not in accordance with God's will and God's ways and His word. And so we need to recognize that the condition of our heart in large part influences how the world sees us, because what's in our hearts flows from us. That's why, Jesus, we talk about Jesus taking up residence in our hearts, Holy Spirit abiding in our hearts. And that's an important recognition for us, that when the joy of the Lord abides in our hearts, the joy of the Lord proceeds from our hearts. And we need to guard our hearts, because Satan, as we know, prowls around like a roaring lion looking for someone to devour. He's looking for a foothold. He's looking for a way into our hearts to destroy us. He's looking for a way into our hearts to make our hearts an unacceptable place for Holy Spirit to abide, for Jesus to take up residence. And that's the way of the world. And so we need to, as Proverbs says, above all else, guard your heart. Guard your heart so that everything that proceeds from it is of God, brings glory to God, lifts high the name of Jesus, reveals His joy and His love and His grace in the words we speak and the things we do. See, when the joy of the Lord abides in our hearts, our desire for things that are not of Him, things that are of the world, have little interest to us. But when our hearts are corrupted by the world, then it's fair game. So guard your heart, friends, in Jesus' name, and keep your heart holy and clean and pure for Him to abide in. And then from you will proceed things of Him. Because when we are in Christ, with Christ, what proceeds from us is of Christ. And that brings glory to His holy name. Let's pray together. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank You and we praise You for Your word, which instructs us and encourages us and helps us to live in a right relationship with You. God, as David prayed in Psalm 51, create in us a clean heart, O God. Make our hearts pure and an acceptable residence for Jesus to abide in us, for the power of Holy Spirit to proceed from us. Lord, may everything we say and do this day bring glory to Your holy name. May everything that proceeds from us be of You, because You abide in us. And Lord, we love You and we want to bring glory to Your holy name. So Lord, guide us and uphold us with Your love and Your grace. In the precious name of Jesus Christ we pray. Amen. Well, friends, thanks for joining me this morning for this short reflection on God's word. I hope that it has been an encouragement to you. We look forward to seeing you tomorrow as we unpack another verse from God's holy scriptures. So friends, go in peace. The Lord bless you and keep you this day and always. Amen. See you tomorrow, friends.